we are, Sol y Luna, which is where we stayed in Montezuma, which means sun and moon. Our little bungalow was just to die for. It was so exquisitely decorated, and it was so comfortable. And I mean, we were literally in nature. There were howler monkeys that were like making all this noise when we first got there. Sounded like Jurassic Park. Oh, this is a coati, cute little bear-like looking animal. And he had been rescued by our host, Patricia, so he was pretty used to humans. And so used to the point that here we are. He's on our porch eating a pineapple. And it was cool. Oh, yeah, this is the bat. Now, I had never seen a bat this close, and it was really cool. But if he had started moving, I would have been on the floor or in the wood. Oh, yeah, frog. Frog in the toilet, okay? Frog, yes. That is a frog in the toilet that we did not put there. He showed up. Pelicans. Love, 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 love pelicans. I went bonkers over pelicans. I took hundreds and hundreds of pictures of freaking pelicans. Not the prettiest bird in the world, but when they fly, oh, it's just spectacular to watch them. And this was their breeding ground, so there were hundreds of them. And at low tide, it was so cool to watch these guys, like, dive and get their fish. It was great. It was absolutely great to watch. And I mean, you know, they're kind of like the mafia. They would keep the frigates out of the water. They would let the egrets hang, but they ain't like the frigates. So they would like have their little area, and they would keep the frigates away from diving. And then there's a little poochie. Well, he's not ours, but you know, he came and showed up, and it was like, oh, a little poochie on the beach. Otherwise, it was our beach. Fishermen, I don't know what that was in there, but it looked impressive. And this is in Kabuya, which is right up the road from where we were staying. Okay, now I'm on the beach in Montezuma, and this little guy had his little construction going on, and Dad was helping. It wasn't the other way around. Again, maybe it was. But, I mean, it was, you see how perfect this thing is? And I tell you, it was very, very fascinating watching the construction. Now, what are they doing? And she doesn't seem to mind. Alrighty then. Okay, now this dude, he was just terrorizing this little girl. It just was not right. But you know, as it always goes, guys will tease, girls will scream, and then they go, do it again, do it again. See, he's making up to it after you made her cry, and then they were best friends. Now, you know I'm into gems. This is red jasper, and it was in all of that granite you just saw. There was a beach that had nothing but agate and jasper, and I went bonkers. It was phenomenal just seeing it in its natural home. And I collected a whole bunch of them, so that's going to show up in jewelry. Little hermit crab who was camouflaged very well. He was not having me find him, and this guy was missing some legs, but he was still pretty. Now, that's a dead stingray. Yeah. He washed up on the beach, and little mollusk there, very fascinating. I mean, I just was captivated. This is a memorial for Nicholas Weisberg, who was an environmentalist. I think of this woman as the mermaid, just sitting there by the ocean. My man was going to eat well. He was going to eat well that night. Look at him grinning. And these, you know, people would pull up their cars and have all kind of wares that they were selling down in Montezuma, which is really funky, funky, fresh, kind of new agey little town. I mean, it's little. Okay, my little shell moment with the feet, you know, that was like petrified wood. Way cool. Way, way, way cool. And this is what brought tears to my eyes. The sunrise, the day we were leaving. It was spectacular, and unfortunately, my little pictures did not do it justice. I couldn't believe how red the sun was. I was like, this is sunrise. Just absolutely magnificent. It was an incredible, incredible, incredible time, and I cannot wait until I get back there.